Good day, everyone. I am Julie Anan Pascua, and today we're gonna learn about the theory of multiple intelligence. When we say intelligence, the only thing that people know is the logical intelligence. Kumbaga, ang alam lang natin na intelligence or talino ng isang tao ay sa eskwelahan or talino sa pag-iisip. But today, one of the great men in the history proved that we are intelligent in our own way, or we are intelligent in some other way. So the proponent or the founder of multiple intelligence is Dr. Howard Gardner. So he was born on July 11, 1943. So he is an American cognitive psychologist and an author best known for his theory of multiple intelligence. So yun nga, as I have said a while ago, he proved that we are intelligent in some other ways. Hindi lang po iisa ang isa ang pagiging matalino natin. Hindi lang pagiging matalino sa pag-iisip. So from the word multiple, talagang marami. Maraming ways kung gaano tayo katalino or paano tayo magiging matalino sa isang bagay. So the theory of multiple intelligence was first proposed by Dr. Howard Gardner in his book in the year 1983 titled Frames of Mind, where he broadens the definition of intelligence and outlines several distinct types of intellectual competencies. So the theory of multiple intelligence was first proposed sa book na pinublish ni Dr. Gardner in the year 1983 titled Frames of Mind. So Gardner defines intelligence as a biopsychological potential to process information that can be activated in a cultural setting to solve problems or create products that are of value in a culture. So ginagamitan natin talaga ng utak ang isang bagay to solve or to figure out something. So sa matatalakay natin later, we will talk about how our body and how our mind coordinates to solve or to figure out something for us at para masabi na dito tayo matalino or sa ibang bagay tayo matalino. So we have 8 types of intelligence according to Howard Gardner. So the first one is the linguistic intelligence. From the word itself, linguistic or language. So allow me to read. So people who are strong in linguistic or verbal intelligence can use words well, both when writing and speaking. So these individuals are typically very good at writing stories, memorizing information, and reading. So basically, ito yung mga authors na nakakapag-produce ng mga books, literary pieces, or literary texts. So if you are good in writing, you are good in reading, and you can produce, you can coordinate your words para makapag-produce ng isang masterpiece, either poem, either stories. So magaling ka sa linguistic intelligence. Like you can coordinate your mind and your heart kung paano makapagsulat ng isang masterpiece under literature. You are good in linguistic intelligence. Malawak yung imagination mo at kaya mong isulat in a creative way yung mga nasa isip mo. Ayan, so that is linguistic intelligence. So the next intelligence is the one of the most famous intelligence in the multiple intelligence, which is the logical or mathematical intelligence. So people who are strong in logical or mathematical intelligence are good at reasoning, recognizing patterns, and logically analyzing problems. So these individuals tend to think conceptually about numbers, relationships, and patterns. For example, you're a student and you always ace your quizzes, exams, post-test, pre-test, summative test. And lagi kang, as I've said a while ago, lagi kang nakakakuha ng mga matataas na scores. And you are belong to those people who have mathematical intelligence. Kasi you are using your logical and critical thinking to figure out and choose the correct answer to those statements or to those questions on the test exams or test paper or exam paper. Ayan. So, sabi niya rin that dito is recognizing patterns. So, nakakapag-memorize siya or nakakapag-recognize siya ng patterns. So, basically or usually, under siya ng mathematics, as we can see that it is mathematical intelligence. So, sa pag-solve ng mga mathematical problem, we have pattern. May yung mga equation, yung mga step-by-step, yung mga pattern to solve a mathematical problem. Ayan. So, those people who can solve or who can like reason out or give solution to problems, mataas ang kanilang logical intelligence. The next intelligence is bodily or kinesthetic intelligence. So, those who have high bodily kinesthetic intelligence are said to be good at body movement, performing actions, and physical control. People who are strong in this area tend to have excellent hand and eye coordination and dexterity. So, in this intelligence, you are able and you are capable to manipulate your body movement. So, those people who are expert in manipulating their hand movement, their legs movement, their emotion, facial expression, are those dancers, athletes, actors, military personnel, because they can coordinate their body and mind to move. Ayan. So, that is bodily or kinesthetic intelligence. Magaling ka, gracefully ka sumayaw, magaling kang mag-basketball, yan, nakaka-coordinate yung mind and body mo na i-shoot yung ball with the nice position, ganyan, para ma-shoot yung ball sa ring. The next intelligence is the visual or spatial intelligence. People who are strong in visual spatial intelligence are good at visualizing things. These individuals are often good with directions, maps, charts, videos, and pictures. So, people who are good in visualizing things, that they can coordinate their mind and their eyes to visualize or imagine things. So, yung mga people na ito is palagi silang nagde-daydream or nag-iisip ng isang bagay. For example, yung isang tao, magaling siya sa directions or he or she can measure distances sa isang map. Ayan, he can read direction, he can read maps, where to direct his or her own self. Sa isang case naman is nakaka-visualize siya na nasa loob siya ng maze, kung paano siya lalabas sa isang maze, sa pag-coordinate lang ng eyes and mind, kung saan niya na-visualize yung sarili niya. Pwede din yung mga questions na sinasabi or tinatanong ng mga teachers natin, where can you see yourself in 10 years? So, if you can see your 10 years as a teacher, as an engineer, na yun talaga yung profession or yung career path na iti-take mo and very much happy ka doon and you can visualize, hindi vague, clear siya na na-visualize mo, you have spatial intelligence. The next intelligence is musical intelligence. People who have strong musical intelligence are good at thinking in patterns, rhythms, and sounds. They have a strong appreciation for music and are often good at musical composition and performance. So those people who have musical intelligence are good in playing musical instruments such as guitars, violin, piano, bass, yung mga ganun, that they can interpret sounds kasama ng rhythms and patterns na hindi kayang gawin ng ibang tao. So, tendency niyan, if they are good in harmonizing, in recognizing patterns and rhythms, they tend to create a masterpiece or musical masterpiece using musical instrument and how they interpret the lyrics or the rhythms. So, basically, yung mga singer-songwriter natin are good in, they are intelligent musically. The next intelligence is the interpersonal intelligence. Those who have strong interpersonal intelligence are good at understanding and interacting with other people. These individuals are skilled at assessing the emotions, motivations, desires, and intentions of those around them. So basically, those people who have interpersonal intelligence ay yung mga social butterflies or extrovert. Madali silang makipagkaibigan, madali silang makipag-usap sa mga ibang tao na hindi kaya din ng ibang tao. Ayan, so basically, sila yung mga nagiging takbuhan ng mga kaibigan nila dahil naiintindihan nila, they understand the emotions, the feelings of the people around them. Kaya, nakakapag-lend sila ng shoulders or hands sa mga taong yon kasi alam nila or alam niya yung pinagdadaanan kasi social butterfly siya or parang nagiging comfortable na yung mga people around him or her para lumapit sa kanya. So, if you're a social butterfly or an extrovert, you can easily make friends with those people who are just new to you, who you just met, and you are making friends with them. Isa ka sa mga tao na may interpersonal intelligence. The next intelligence is the intrapersonal intelligence. This is the opposite of the interpersonal. If we have said a while ago that interpersonal is a social butterfly or extrovert, intrapersonal is the opposite, which those people are introverts. So individuals who are strong in intrapersonal intelligence are good at being aware of their own emotional states, feelings, and motivation. They tend to enjoy self-reflection and analysis, including daydreaming, exploring relationships with others, and assessing their personal strength. So yung mga introvert that they can enjoy the solitude of the moment. Hindi nila kailangan ng company ng ibang tao for them to make something or to figure out something or to make themselves better or good. So hindi nila kailangan ng ibang tao to make them feel better. Kaya kailangan lang nilang i-assess yung sarili nila and they can figure out something or they can figure out their problems and can solve them by their own intelligence. Ayan. That is intrapersonal intelligence who can enjoy their alone time or solitude time na hindi kailangan ng presence ng ibang tao. Ayan. And also, they can be productive alone. Kaya nilang makagawa ng mga tasks nila sa sarili lang nila. The next one is naturalistic intelligence. So according to Gardner, individuals who are high in this type of intelligence are more in tune with nature and are often interested in nurturing, exploring the environment, and learning about other species. These individuals are said to be highly aware of even subtle changes to their environment. So basically, yung mga naturalist or naturalistic people ay yung mga botanist. Yung mga gustong-gusto nila yung mga plants sa environment, mga trees, ganyan, minamahal nila. Or they value the environment, the natural environment around them. Like tinitake care nila yung mga trees. For example, yung nakita ko online na isang advocate ng environment, na isang babae, gustong-gusto niya magtanim ng puno. Then, the government issued a paper na ikakat down nila yung 1,000 trees sa isang area para pagtayuan ng isang mall. Ngayon, that girl became upset with that news. Kaya, she protested through climbing one of the trees in that area and lived there for 2 months. So, yung mga kapwa advocate niya, environmental advocate niya, sila yung nagpapadala or nagdadala ng pagkain sa kanya for that span of 2 months para lang maging aware yung government na hindi kailangan na putulin yung mga trees na nandun kasi mahalaga siya for the environment. So, kung ganun ka, if you really love and enjoy the nature, isa ka sa mga naturalist, isa ka sa mga mayroon ng naturalistic intelligence. And we have the last type of multiple intelligence, which is the existential intelligence. So this is just an addition to Gardner's original theory. He described existential intelligence as an ability to develop into deeper questions about life and existence. People with this type of intelligence contemplate the big questions about topics such as the meaning of life and how actions can serve larger goals. Ayan. These questions ever crossed your minds ba? Like, what's the meaning of my life? Totoo ba si God? Totoo ba yung God? What's next after death? Meron pa bang life after death? So those questions na minsan or kadalasan na nagko-cross sa mind natin has a big impact to us. For example, as a student, what is the meaning of my life as a student? If we contemplate this thing na nag-exist ka as a student, can you make a change or can you make an impact to your surrounding as a student lang? For example, isipin natin nag-exist tayo as a student. Kung mawala tayo sa mundo, may maiiwan ba tayong legacy? May nagawa ba tayong mabuti para those people around us can remember us about the good things we did? Or kung mawala ka tapos wala kang naging effect during your existence sa surroundings mo, maaalala ka ba or hindi? So that is the meaning of that. Gawin nating meaningful na yung isang bagay or yung existence natin to make a larger goal or to make an impact or change to our surrounding or environment. Ayan. So those are the 8 intelligence that we have discussed. Ano na yung mga ulit na yon? So we have the spatial intelligence, the spatial or visual intelligence, linguistic or verbal intelligence, the intrapersonal, interpersonal intelligence, logical, mathematical intelligence. We have the musical, bodily, kinesthetic, and naturalistic intelligence. So after discussing the different types of multiple intelligence, we are now indulging ourselves if we really understood the discussion. So we have the evaluation part of this discussion. So I'll just flash on the screen the different statements, and you must identify those statements if they are belong to what type of multiple intelligence. So just write your answer and send it to the comment box. That's all for this day. I hope that you learned something about the multiple intelligence, and I am confident that you can now evaluate yourself kung anong intelligence ang meron ka ngayon, and you must cultivate and develop it para magamit mo pa in the near future. Thank you so much, and God bless.